Ever before Grand Theft Auto V was taking headlines, the previous game of the series was getting a lot of press, for a very different reason. Grand Theft Auto IV was a brilliant analysis into the underbelly of the concept of the American dream. It is also a terrible PC port for everyone, not just people with low-end computers, but thanks to an active modding community, we may be able to downgrade it maybe a bit too much? This is the Low Spec Gamer, where we sometimes spend hours just figuring out how to get a game to boot up without a dedicated video card. So, forget about details on cars, NPCs and trees, because we're making this game run.
Oh, I hope that didn't hurt as badly as it looked.
I wish I could show you how GTA 4 runs on this computer, but I can't, because the game will simply not start on some integrated GPUs. Here's how I solve it, maybe it can work for you too. First, you need to go to the installation folder of GTA 4. For Steam, this is located at your program files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Grand Theft Auto 4, GTA 4. Inside, you can create a text file called commandline.txt, where the game will read commands on startup. You need this command, available bitmem, where you can specify your video memory. To find out how much to put here, you need to go to your control panel, display settings, advanced, and it will be in megabytes under the dedicated video memory. You need to put a number that is under that in the command. Be sure to include the decimal point and the zero, it will not work otherwise. Now the game will be able to open and it will drop us into the minimum settings possible. The only thing I have changed is the resolution to 720p. Testing this does not seem that good at first, but it becomes obvious that we can barely pull over 25fps sometimes. Let's see what we can do. If you have something like the Steam version of this game, chances are you're using the latest game version. Some people report a slight performance difference from previous versions, and some mods will not work on the latest one. To downgrade, we will follow the instructions on the PC Gaming Wiki, which are linked on the description. This involves downloading the 1.0.4 update and installing it, renaming the GTA 4 folder with all your files, installing Social Club and then moving all the files from your rename folder to the GTA 4 folder that should have been created when you installed the Social Club. Follow the instructions on that wiki and you shall be fine. Also, remember to set the properties of the game on Steam so the game does not update automatically, and create a shortcut to the GTA 4 launcher to your desktop so you can play without it updating. And now, before we move into mod territory, I highly suggest you back up your common and PC folders from the GTA 4 directory, that way you can revert the effect of any mod. The first two mods I'm going to try make very slight changes, and they give you a slight boost in performance. The first is called FPS Boost for low specs, and the second one is the GTA 4 Optimizer. Try these two mods separately and keep the one that works best for you. To install the first one, you need to copy the timeseek.dat to your PC data folder, replacing the original file and then copying the visualsettings.dat to your common data folder, also replacing the original file. If you decide to try the second one, then inside the mod folder you just need to copy the PC and common folder and paste them on the GTA 4 directory, merging and replacing all the necessary files. I pretty much saw the same effects with both mods plus the version downgrade. FPS is slightly more stable now and seems to be between 28 and 30 in the good moments. However, if you're truly desperate, there might be a more interesting option. Behold, the appropriately named GTA 4 for extremely low PCs, a mod with some dramatic changes to the regular game. The link is in the description. The download leads to a collection of mod assets that you can use. I recommend the Extreme Low PC Base Package, the Props Removal, and the No Card Deformation. To install the base package, copy the Common and PC folders on the downloaded mod files to your GTA 4 folder, overriding everything that it needs to. There's also a commandline.txt that you may add to your existing command list. In my experience, beyond lowering the resolution, the commands did nothing special, but experiment with each one of them if you still need additional performance. For the no card deformation mod, simply copy and paste the common folder included in the mod. And the same for the PC folder for the props removal, you probably have the grasp of this by now. Let's see what it did. Okay, so the door is gone. It's not that it's open, there's no door, but who needs those anyway? Yep, no doors and... Whoa, okay. Oh my god. Is that the draw distance? That is absolutely the draw distance. Holy shit. Is this how an Age of Empires soldier feels? Right, so if you're not desperate enough to use that draw distance, you can try one last thing. This draw distance mod includes files for different in-game draw distances. The shortest one included seems to work very well with this mod. Otherwise, you can just copy the timeseek file from the backup I told you to create. You did backup your files, didn't you? In any case, I'm going to use the shorter one in the mod and copy it to PC data. I'm going to delete the super short one and rename the modded one to simply timeseek.dat so the game can recognize it. Done. Time for some testing. So, as you can see, the draw distance isn't that bad this time. You can still see where it cuts in the distance, but it's not as dramatically bad, isn't it? The NPCs look interesting. Look at this car. Isn't this a beautiful, exciting car? Don't you want to drive this kind of car? Now, check this out. If I try to use this car... Wait for it. So I get into the car, bop, and it morphs. Beautiful. So that way you know that details are loaded only on the car that you're driving. That's how you make maximum performance, people. And we're getting one hell of a performance boost compared to before. It's magical. Ah, I missed my exit. Typical. Wow. Also the trees, I had not realized that. Nice looking trees. Oh, that's even better. Time to integrate myself into this car. Whoop. Never gets old. Time to go for the bridge. This is usually where my performance drops the most, and well, check it out. Much better than I expected. Oh, I didn't see that. Ah, crap, it's the graphics police. I have gone too far. I have downgraded this too much and now they are out to get me. Look at their cars. How are you supposed to catch me when your cars aren't even rendered? Get out of my way. Follow the dealer to his supplier on foot. Stay behind him and try not to be seen. Don't get so close to a brother. Well, that was bad. Here we go. Do I have to catch him or do I have to kill him? I don't remember. Oh, that works. Oh, crap. Looking nice. Hello. That's one intimidating looking enemy. Hello, Mr. Tree. Whoa! Okay, I guess they did remove trees. I knew the mod mentioned that trees were removed, and I saw these and thought, eh, they didn't really remove them, but... Well, I was wrong.
I'm robbing you. Don't make me.
Whoa! This is so bizarre looking! Boop! Never gets old. Never gets old! Am I being chased? I think I am. Oh sh! Run button! Run button! Crap! Ah. Ouch. And the car returned back into its low model almost immediately. Out of my way! Shoot! For a one-star chase, this is sure being hard to shake. Right. This is all for this video. Boy, am I glad this is finally done. The demand for this video has been overwhelming. As usual, thank you to my very generous Patreon contributors. If you want to support me and help me achieve some exciting goals like an exclusive soundtrack and tweaking games on Mac, this is the best way. And now, Lowspec Gamer Giveaway! Last time I asked if you'd like to finish the basic game or go for a competition, and the winners are Kigiro Kuro, Stuff Plays Look, and the original PSI. Congratulations! The question for this week is the following. Do you prefer to play games in their original state, or do you always mod the f*** out of everything? For this week, the prizes are not GTA 5, 4 comments, yes, hilarious, I know, and 2 copies of Gunstar Heroes for Twitter and the Steam group. And for Facebook, oh wait, right, Lowspec Gamer is now on Facebook because too many people complain about not having Twitter. Help me share these videos on your social platform of choice. To celebrate this wondrous occasion, if you answer the question on the comments of this video on Facebook, you can win a copy of GTA 4, this very same game, so you can try this yourself. Thank you to all the game donors. See you on the next video. Oh, I was so... Oh no, I was doing so well.